Hi, and welcome to SSIS 101. Today we're going to review how to retrieve data from a REST API using the SSIS REST API task. From Visual Studio 2013, go to File, New Project. Under Templates, Business Intelligence, select Integration Services Project. I'm going to call my project REST API Demo. Click OK to create the project. If you don't see the SSIS toolbox, right-click in the blank space, select SSIS Toolbox. You should see a set of tasks that start with ZS. These are the SSIS tasks. Drag and drop the ZS REST API task onto the Control Flow tab. Double-click the task to edit its properties. The first tab are the request settings. Here we have the URL endpoint of our REST API. Enter the URL for the API you wish to connect to. Next is the request method. We support the following request methods: get, post, put, delete, head, and list. For instance, if you need to submit data via post request, the HTTP request data input area will become enabled. There you could specify the request body, for instance, first name, last name, and so on. For now, let's just keep it simple and do a get request. You can also specify HTTP headers, like an authorization header. To test the output, we hit test request response. We can see it returned a successful response and even look at the structure of the data returned. Next, we'll navigate to the response settings tab. Here we'll specify how we want the response to be saved. We can save it as a variable that can be used in downstream tasks, or we can output the data to a file. In this case, we'll save it to a variable. We can create a new variable and I'll name it var response. We also want to specify what content type the response should be. In this case, we know our response will be JSON, so we'll select JSON. Let's test the response again. Notice that the JSON response has two objects, a string named odata metadata and an array named value. We only want the data located in the value object. In the response filter text box, we specify value. Let's test the response again. Great, we're only getting back the array of values. The last tab allows us to validate the response. One way to validate the response is based on the status code. We can also validate based on the content returned or the headers. We want to fail this task if it returns a status code other than 200. Now that the task is configured, let's test it. I'm going to send the data coming from the REST API task to the ZS logging task. I'll drag it over from the SSIS toolbox and connect it to the REST API task. Double-click the task to edit its properties. We can log data coming into this task to either the execution log, a message box, or a file. I'm going to log it to a message box. We're going to delete the default message and instead use the variable we created to hold our response. Click OK, and now we can test the task. Save, click Start, and there we have it. We can see the response returned from the API. This has been an overview of how to get data from a REST API using the SSIS REST API task. For more videos like this, subscribe to the SSIS YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.